Good evening, everyone. In the last session, we were discussing force and extension. We discussed MCQs and did question one. Today, we'll solve question two onward. So in this question two, in an experiment, forces are applied to a spring as shown. So you can see there's a spring and we are applying the forces. How we are applying the forces? By adding a load. So when we add a load, a force is applied on the spring, and when we add or increase more load, the extension will also increase. And this is the graph for the force and extension. We are increasing the force, extension is increasing throughout this graph, but from starting point till Q, it is directly proportional. From Q to R, when we are increasing the force, extension is also increasing, but because it is a curve, so it shows that it does not follows or obeys a Hooke's law. So when it is a straight line, it means it obeys the Hooke's law. When it is a curve, it does not obey the Hooke's law. So in the first part, what is the name given to a point? Mark Q on the figure. So what we call this, the last point where this line is straight, so the last point where this line is straight and a spring is obeying the Hooke's law, we call that as limit of proportionality or proportionality limit. So what label is given to Q, the last point where the line is straight, we call that as proportionality limit, or you can also write limit of proportionality. The second part, for the part OP of a graph, the spring obeys the Hooke's law. What this means? Basically, they're asking, what is the definition of a Hooke's law, or what is the statement of a Hooke's law? So Hooke's law state that force is directly proportional to extension. So for part B, the answer will be the force is directly proportional to extension for part O to P because it is a straight line. Then part C, the spring is stretched until the force and extension are shown by point R. So the point R is representing, as the spring is further stretched, point R is also there. Compare how the spring stretches as shown from part of a graph from O to Q and then from Q to R. So we have to compare the graph from O to Q and then from Q to R. So what we can say from O to Q, because it is a straight line, so we can say that the force and extension are directly proportional. Because whenever there's a straight line, it means two quantities are directly proportional. If you are increasing the one quantity, the other is also increasing with the same rate. But from Q to R, what happened? Force and extension are not directly proportional. And why they are not directly proportional? Because it is not a straight line, it is a curve. Is it clear? The part C. So when you have a straight line, it means force and extension are directly proportional. If it is a curve, it means force and extension are not directly proportional. You are increasing the force, extension is also increasing, but not with the same value. Then for the part O and P, calculate for the part O and P of a graph show that the spring stretches according to the expression F is equals to Kx, use a value, find the value of a K. So we need a spring constant. So if we need a spring constant, we can take the value of the force. So here each box is representing 0.4. So 12.4, 12.8, 13.2, 13.6, and this will be 14. Force will be 14. And what about extension on x-axis? Each box is representing 0.2, so 2.2, 2.4, 2.6, 2.8, 3.2, 3.4, and it is between 3.4 and 3.6, so this will be 3.5. So we need k. How to get the value of the k? The spring constant, that is force divided by extension. So we are applying a force of 14 and the extension is 3.5. So 14 divided by 3.5, we will get the value for K. So it will come out as 4. The unit of force is Newton and unit of extension according to axis is given in millimeter. So it will be Newton per millimeter. Is it clear how we work out the value of the K, the spring constant? As the value of the K is equals to force divided by extension. So we have the force and we have the extension. So we divide them, we will get the value of spring constant. And I can take any part. It is not necessary that I should take the last point. I can take any part of this straight line. Like example, if I took this point P. So when I took this point P, the force is 8. And when I find the extension, that is 2. So force divided by extension will get the value of K. So 8 divided by 2, I'll get 4 Newton per millimeter. So you can clearly see that I can take any point on this straight line to work out the value of the K or the spring constant. In question 3, state Hooke's law. So what is the statement of Hooke's law? It states force or extension of a spring is directly proportional to load applied. So what load we will apply? If we increase the load, the extension, the change in the size will also increase with the same rate. In part B, figure 1.1 shows a graph for stretching force acting on a spring against the extension. So force is on y-axis and extension on x-axis. Extension here is represented by x. State the feature of the graph that show that it is obeying a Hooke's law. So by looking at this graph, how you can say that it is obeying a Hooke's law? Number one, you will mention it is a straight line starting from origin. Because whenever two quantities are directly proportional, it should be a straight line. The graph between the quantity should be a straight line which is passing through origin. So whenever there is a straight line passing through origin, it shows that two quantities are directly proportional. Example, if there is another graph, I have force on y-axis and I have length on x-axis, and the graph was a straight line but it was not passing through origin, it was like this. Can I say force and length are directly proportional? Yes or no? Can I say force and length are directly proportional? Is it true or false? So we cannot say force and length are directly proportional because the reason is that the question, my question is, can I say that force and length are directly proportional from this graph? We have force on y-axis and length on x-axis, and this was a graph. So we cannot say force and length are directly proportional. That's wrong. Why? Because it is a straight line, but it is not starting from origin. So whenever two quantities are directly proportional, there should be a straight line which is starting from origin. So in this question, in this part, they ask, state the feature of the graph that the spring that shows that the spring obeys a Hooke's law. What is a Hooke's law? Hooke's law state force and extension are directly proportional. So whenever two quantities are directly proportional, the graph between the two quantities will be a straight line and it will always start from origin. Is it clear? In mathematics, you will study about Hooke's law, the proportionality relations as well. So whenever the quantities are directly proportional, there should be a straight line which is passing through origin. Then calculate the value of a spring constant. Look, Abdullah, in the question they ask, figure 1.1 shows the stretching force acting against on the spring against extension. So there is a graph between force and extension. In the question, they are saying state the feature of the graph that shows that spring is obeying a Hooke's law. So by looking at this graph, how we can say the spring is obeying a Hooke's law? Whenever, because according to Hooke's law, we say according to Hooke's law, we say force is directly proportional to extension. So by looking at this graph, how we can say that force is directly proportional to extension? So whenever two quantities are directly proportional, number one, it should be a straight line. Number one. And number two, the line should start from the origin. Origin means this should be the starting point of the line. So whenever a line is starting from origin and it is a straight line, it means that two quantities are directly proportional. So if a spring is obeying a Hooke's law, it means force is directly proportional to extension. And what should be the graph? By look, what feature of the graph shows that it obey a Hooke's law? So it is a straight line and it is passing through origin. But for example, if there is another graph and we say that we have a graph between force and length, can I say that force and length are directly proportional if the graph was like this? So I don't say that force and length are directly proportional. Why? Because it is a straight line, but it is not starting from origin. Is it clear, Abdullah Sarfraz? So, what feature of the graph shows it is obeying a Hooke's law? It is a straight line passing through origin. Then calculate the value of the spring constant K. So how we can calculate the value of spring constant? For that we need the force. We can take any value of the straight line. We can take any part here. The force is there and we can work out the extension. The value of the K is equals to force divided by extension. You can extension can be denoted by E or X, that does not make difference. So force is 100 and extension is 40. 100 divided by 40 is 2.5 Newton per millimeter. So extend the value of the K or the spring constant in this example is 2.5 Newton per millimeter. The next part, the limit of proportionality of a spring is reached when the extension is 50 millimeter. So means till 50 millimeter, it will be a straight line. When the extension is 50 millimeter, it is a straight line. Continue the graph in figure 1.1 to show how the spring behaves when the stretching force is increased above the value of 125. So till this point it is obeying a Hooke's law, but after that it does not obey a Hooke's law. They mentioned we reach a limit of proportionality. So if a spring does not obey a Hooke's law, what will happen? We further increase the force, but extension will not increase with the same rate. So how we represent that? We represent it by a curve. So it will be a curve after this point. Another spring has a, having a smaller value of a K, and this spring obeys a Hooke's law up to 80 millimeter. On the grid, draw a possible line. So this is a graph. This is one of the graphs already given to us, and we completed after this 50 millimeter. It does not obey the Hooke's law. So as it does not obey the Hooke's law, it will be a curve. Now they are saying, and the value of the K for this spring, which we worked out, that was 2.5 Newton per millimeter. Now they are saying we have to sketch another graph for a spring which is having a smaller value of a K, and it obey the Hooke's law up to 80 millimeter. So it will be a straight line till 80 millimeter, but it is a smaller value of a K. So which one I should draw? It should be above the first one or below the first one? Which one is the right? You can use the chat or screen annotation to state which one is the right correct line for a smaller value of a K. The spring with a smaller value of a K, A or B. The spring with a smaller value of a K means which is easy to stretch, because higher value of a K means spring will be difficult to stretch. A smaller value of a K means spring will be easy to stretch. So when you check the graph, you can clearly identify that if I, for B, very small force can produce a greater extension. So the correct line is actually the second one, or B. Is it clear, this part? We have to draw a line for a spring which is having a smaller value of a K, or which is easy to stretch, and it obey the Hooke's law till 80 millimeter. That is why we are drawing a straight line, as they mentioned in the question, that this spring obeys the Hooke's law. Another spring which is having a smaller value of a K, and it obey the Hooke's law till 80 millimeter. So it should be a straight line till 80 millimeter. So these are some questions related to force and extension.